What's up, everybody? Not what's everybody. What's up, everybody? All right, T-Bone's helping me out. We're doing the live stream tonight. We're doing the best guacamole ever. So if you're watching this on the repeat, stick around. There'll probably be a little delay while we wait for people to join on. So hang out. What up, Scotty? All right, hold on. Let me flip this bad boy around. So, hi, Trent. All right, here you go. Loaded. Hey, Miss J, how you doing? Say hi, Trent.
Hi, Miss J.
Cheers, guys. So, do you read the chat? Trent's chowing down on some Twix right now. All right, guys, we're going to wait for a little bit. We're going to... But people gonna get on, get going. How many people are on the chat or watching?
Seven.
Right on. Y'all do me a favor, if you're here, get in the chat, say what's up. That's it. And I'll get going in a few minutes here. But I need to hydrate. Cheers, y'all. Don't leave a mess. Check. Got it. What happened to the music? I'm cleaning up my mess as I go, don't worry. Get yourself another drink, Miss Jay. So, I did the shopping. I took our middle son, Zachary, to the store to get all this stuff. And I got everything I needed except chips. So luckily, my oldest, Trent T-Bone, has his license now. So I was able to send him to the store. That's funny. Don't care about the mess, just your food. I love it. So we're going to get me some chips. We got some fresh chips to go with the guacamole we're going to put down tonight. This is kind of the first time I've done a live stream that we're I'm actually kind of making something. I've done some preparation live streams, but I haven't really done, you know, actual making of a dish. So we'll see how this goes. Who knows? Tell me if the music's too loud in the background. Trent's got his hip hop on. What the shit you know about guacamole? Chef Johnny, I'm from Southern California. We're like a high skip and a jump away from Mexico. Of course I know guacamole. I bastardized it the California way, but, you know, it's freaking good. You wouldn't turn it down. You need to give me some of that Lone Star shit. Got my meathead knife. I'm ready to do this. Hack. I'm getting kinked. You want one of these, don't you? Haha, can't have one. Marion, what's up, brother? You need to take a drive up to 15, come see me. Little girl hands. You can handle this, buddy. You don't want none. Got the whole crew in the house. Run on. All right, guys, let's get this started. So we got some ripe avocados, and what I've done already, so this is going to be our little mixing bowl. I've already done some stuff on the grill, okay? So I'm sorry if I'm kind of looking down here, but I want to see what the people are saying, and Trent, you know, if you see someone pop up with a question, then let me know, okay?
Kirby, I told you, you guys grab Kirby, grab Marion, head up to 15, come find us. Alright, so what I did before we got started on the live stream is I grilled some of the vegetables I'm gonna put in this guacamole. And you said vegetables, well, I have jalapenos, I got some corn, and I got a little bit of tomatoes. I'm just gonna chop up a little tomatoes in there, okay? So let's start. I got little bowls here to put all this crap in. So let's just start with the corn. Let's see if I can make a big ass mess with it. I was inspired to do this by watching Steve from Not Another Cooking Channel. I'm sorry, Not Another Cooking Show. And he made a great guacamole this week. And I told him that I really enjoy putting roasted corn and bacon in my guacamole. So what I have already, I have some cooked bacon already. So you see that? Got some cooked bacon already chopped up. So I grilled this corn, got some nice char marks on there, and roasted it up real good. I heard it popping out there, so it was good stuff. So this is not some old family recipe here. This is stuff I've just kind of enjoyed making over the years. So the way I've liked to make my guacamole over the years. Okay. Hi, Emmy. Ems? Right on. Thanks for stopping by. 509 Flavors. Good evening. How you doing? Phil from Daddy Cooks, you graced us with your presence. Love it, buddy. Thanks for stopping by. Yes, yes, Scott, it's corn guac. Thanks. All right, so like I said, I grilled up these jalapenos too. So I'm just gonna chop off the skins. I don't want it too hot. Well, Kirby, I kind of smoked the chilies, but it's in here. Tovito, what's up? How you doing? Chop these up. I want these a little bit more fine. We'll put these in a little dish right here. I grilled two just in case, but I think one will be fine. We just want the little flavor, a little heat in there. Let's see if we can make it through a live stream without cutting my fingers. Telling you guys, you gotta try this. The way I make this guacamole, like I said, a Cali-fied, bastardized guacamole. It's not your normal way of doing things, but I tend to enjoy it. It don't suck. If Melissa's still on there, she can vouch for me. She likes my guacamole. Right, so that looks like a good amount. This cooking and preparing stuff kind of freaking me out. And I'm just gonna take a little of this tomato, kind of cut around the seeds. I'm not trying to put a whole lot in there. I'm gonna peel some of the skin off. Put that back in there. And it's gonna mush pretty good, but I just want the grill flavor in there. So I'm gonna cut some of the skin off.
Malia says your guacamole doesn't suck.
My guacamole doesn't suck. That's I don't know if that's a good endorsement. So the last thing I did, and we'll add this one where we're mixing it up, but I grilled the lime, okay? So, hey, cooking with a little spice. How you doing? All right, so we put this over here. Put these over here. I'm gonna wash up my hands real quick. Just keep it down on this. Check me out. Here. Zoom in. All right, so for those who catch me on. All right, so that's the roasted jalapenos, the roasted corn, the roasted tomato, which I just had a little bit in there, and then the bacon that I cooked up and chopped up already. And we got 4 ripe avocados over here. Well, Phil, I'm glad you made it from parts unknown. It's very important that you know what you're doing over there. You're doing good things, so you know we appreciate you. Man, this music sucks. Anybody, any Nicki Minaj fans on there? So I got me a, no, Malise is not a Nicki Minaj fan. Let's see what else we can find on the radio. This is driving me nuts. It's worse than Cardi B. My God. Contemporary Christian, gospel, anybody? No? Right. How about pop hits? I'll go with that. No love songs. No Nicki from me. Alright, I don't know who this is, but it's good enough. Alright, so I got this handy dandy tool to scrape out. Alright, so I'm gonna put it in here. Alright, cool. Let's see if we can do this. What? Look at that. That's interesting. Let's push that through. Alright. This is an interesting little tool here. You see it? Sorry, my arm's in the way. Push it down, push it through. Alright. Kind of takes the part of cutting, you know, how they crosshatch, cutting up avocado. Alright, turn it back here. Alright. Guys, make sure you're hitting that like button for me, please.
I hit 6 right now.
The unpredictable part about going live. Nice. Just so I know, everybody can hear, right? Everybody can hear me? You know what's up in the chat? If you can hear me fine. Big like, love sent. Thank you. It's a little bit better than Nicki Minaj on there. Sounds good. Thank you, sir. Fumble! Pick that one up later. You know what? Just remember, this is an actual tool to get the pit out. See? Alright, look at that. 12 in the chat? What? I have 12 people interested in what I have to say? Go team.
50 in chat, 11 likes.
Alright, let's go. Guys, I may or may not have cut myself on that fumble, but you know, we're powering through. It wouldn't be a live stream if I didn't cut myself. So far, every live stream I've done, I've cut myself. It's hard to do a bowl. Come on over, Marion. Let's do this. Right on. Tovia, thank you for stopping by. We'll check you later. Cheers, brother. Yeah, for sure, Phil. I'm a big fan of Anthony Bourdain. It's very sad what happened to him. Me head was shaking, brother. Yeah, it's very sad what happened to him. Let's keep it on there. It just goes to show, you know, no matter what you have or how much you think someone's happy or not, you just never know. You never know what people are going through, right? Mihen, what's up, brother? All right, so that tool's done. Mihen, you missed all the cutting with the dope knife. Fame and fortune, not all that. Yeah, you're right, Chef. Yeah, for sure. It's tough, man. It's a lot of pressure on these guys, I guess, and maybe that's what made them hurt. I was actually talking to Trent about it earlier, and I just can't believe that, you know, he left the daughter. That's the hardest part. He left the little girl that's about the age of our middle kids. So that's it's pretty sad, you know? But I don't know, he did what he felt like he needed to do, I guess. Which is very, very sad. Yeah, she's 11. That's what we were talking about too. 61 years old. You think he could, you know, find some help or, you know, whatever. But Mike, how you doing, big guy? Thanks for stopping by. I'm just making some guac, but I'm doing it my special way. I got my own kind of ingredients. Got bacon. Little roasted tomato, roasted corn, roasted jalapeno, a grilled up, the wine. So we're gonna put, and I just got all the guacamole out. All right, so let's put this together. Now guys, I'm about to introduce you to my guacamole secret ingredient. All right, I was turned onto this a long, long time ago, but I absolutely love it. And it's totally cheating. This stuff here, Concord Farms guacamole mix. It is the best seasoning for guacamole there ever was. Believe me now, hear me later. Or hear me now, believe me later. This stuff is the truth. All right, so we're gonna add this to it.
Isn't that what Hansa Franz said?
Cheater. Hansa Franz, yeah, maybe. Listen, you have your own way, I have mine. I'm telling you guys, this stuff is the truth. So I'm trying to read. Yes, and this is the real deal. Cheater, Jake. What up, Jake? Big Jake in the house. So glad you're here. Tell Stacy I said hi. Give my love to the wife. Miss you guys. I need you guys to come out. Come say hi. Can you come over and check us out? All right. Guys, Jake Huttner there, that guy is a barbecue channel waiting to happen. He is another Southern California guy, and he's on Instagram, so I get to see him. I still get to keep in touch with him, and he is cooking awesome, awesome stuff. He makes brisket ribs. He's got a smoker, loves a good whiskey, fits right in. He's a good dude. All right, so we're putting the bacon in now. All right, last of that. All right, little salt and pepper. Jake, you need to get a channel, brother. We have some fun with this, dude. We'll do some collabs. We'll come up, come out, whatever. I put a lot of pepper in there. I love it. Radishes are awesome. You know, you're right, buddy. Yes, Emmy, this is fully loaded. meathead, I'm not into radishes. But I get where you're coming from. All right, so we got a little of this pink Himalayan sea, or regular salt, not sea salt. So I feel like I'm competing with... All right, cool. Appreciate it, Kirby. All right, so one of the things I love to do is I got some of this pico de gallo that's already made, and I just love squeezing the juice in there. So we're just getting a little of that flavor, wetting it down a little bit. All right, it's totally a waste of a pico de gallo deal here, but I love the juice from pico de gallo. And it just saved me some time from having to build it myself. All right. So, last thing, we got this, got these limes that I've already did the deal with. All right, let's go. Feel the strength. Oh, I'm having too much fun. All right, we're gonna do just one lime for now. I think that's enough. All right, now let's just mix. Move this over here. I don't want to get guacamole on your phone, T-Bone. Viking strength. Stud. Everybody who don't know, Melise is Mrs. CJ, who I always talk about. Phil, take care, brother. Be safe, dude. Thank you for all you do, man. Oh, yeah. Miss J, I'm digging it, too. I'm going to have to do more of this stuff. Pico juice. I know you're making fun of me, Chef Johnny, but I guarantee you, if you try this, you'd be like, give me a bag of chips. Give me a bag of chips, some Lone Stars, and call it a day. All right? So there it is. You can get a close-up on that. Oh yeah, look at that. You can see the white corn in it. It's a sweeter corn. I'm loving it. I'm into the, okay, cool. The bacon in there, I cut it real fine. So we get plenty of that bacon flavor in there. Right, let's get the taste test. Boom. Love it. All right. Whoa. All right. Got our deli fresh chips. Get a nice scoop. We're gonna test the seasoning on it. Mm. Yeah! I don't do nothing to this. Mm. Good Lord, that's a lot of flavor. Mmm. All right. Oh, that's good. All right, good stuff. I don't need any more seasoning. That little packet of seasoning, I don't even know what's in it. Let's look what's in it. That badness. Yeah, Chef, these are dope, man. Jay, get your ass over here, brother. I'm right off the 15. Take you 30 minutes to get here. Come on down the line. All right, what's in this shit? It's a great new flavor. That's what I know. All right, so we got salt, onion, garlic powder, extracts of red pepper, dehydrated red pepper, sour cream powder, natural flavor, buttermilk whey, lemon juice powder, parsley. So, somewhat natural. Can you say white girl wasted? Can't, you know I'm white girl wasted. Ah, you nut bear. Hold tight, stay on. You don't have to follow me. Oh. Excuse me. Pressure. Kent, you're the man, dude. I love you. Freshie.
Cheers. Riley Kidd, what's up, man? How you doing? Thanks for showing up. Now you want some guac. Make it! Hi, Simple Culinary, how you doing? Yeah, meathead, I added bacon. I had it already chopped up, so you didn't see me cut it up in here. Don't need more lime, so this goes in the throwaway basket. Good stuff. Thank you for stopping by. You missed all the good parts, though. We just did, let's finish up this guac right here. Get in there. There you go. Yes, sir, Abraham.
Someone's asking about the mix.
The mix. Who asked? What is that?
Emmy, I think.
Emmy, ask your question again. I think I missed this one. Can I order it online? Is there a website? Hold on, let me check. Yeah, concordfoods.com.
I don't know if you can get it to you. Not at the bottom there? You see it? Got it? Close enough.
What kind of knife is that? Well, I'd like to show you my Serbian kitchen knife, courtesy of meatheadknives.com. Everybody needs one of these. The link below will be a place you can buy this from. Very good quality, sharp, handmade, but not unaffordable. So you'll love it. The knife is awesome. Thank you. What do you think? What do you think, Chris? You think I could be a spokesperson, spokesmodel? Hey, baby. Little Viking war axe. It's a beast, man. I need to clean it off. Nigel, how you doing? Good to see you, hear you. Read you? Alright. Ah, that's good stuff. How long have we been on?
27.
27 minutes? Yeah, not bad. Well, I'm gonna have another bite of guacamole. Talk amongst yourselves. Oh, yeah. Pumped up. Mimi, you're going to finish cleaning this up on Sunday when you get home? That would be awesome. Thank you. What's the beer of choice tonight? It is a cider. I've been hip to this pineapple cider lately. It's an Ace pineapple craft cider. This stuff is 5% alcohol by volume. So good. Hell no. Come on now. Of course I'll clean up. So rude. All right, Miss J, take care. Appreciate stopping by. Cheers. Yeah, Brian, this stuff's the truth, man. It's so good. And I'm gonna make another video this weekend, and here's the thing. I'm okay with girl drinks or foo-foo drinks or drinks that need an umbrella and 14 pieces of fruit with it. This, alright, I got a, sorry, tangent. I got like 3 beautiful ribeyes. They were on sale. I had to buy them, so we'll have that Sunday night. Anyway, I have no problem drinking those things. I drink what's delicious. All right, I love delicious alcohol or drinks, whatever. So I am okay with announcing to the world that I like a pineapple cider because it's damn good. All right, but so I'm gonna make a cocktail this weekend, and it's a sangria of sorts, but it's delicious, and it's one I made before, and it takes a little bit of time. You gotta let it sit for a little while,
But it's so good. It's just, it's like apple pie sangria. So it's going to be great. I'm going to film that this weekend. I got a burger I'm filming for another collaboration. I got to do some editing on the paella video. Got a lot of stuff to do this weekend. So, Mai Tais. Hell yeah, Brian. I love me some Mai Tais. And why that's all I'm drinking is Mai Tais. Oh, that and lava flows. Oh, so good. I already added lime, Gregor. Not a fan of cilantro, so I didn't add it. This is my guacamole, but as everybody knows, guacamole can be personalized. This one has, strawberry cider. Nigel, I'm going to look for that. I'm a big fan of strawberry, so I'm going to look for that. Magners. Okay, I got that. I'm going to look that up. Okay, so Gregor, you kind of missed what we put in here, I think. I don't know if you did or not. There's garlic powder in it. I did not do garlic cloves. I think there was enough kind of garlic flavor in there. I got roasted jalapenos, roasted corn, bacon, roasted tomatoes, and that's it. How about some old duels? You know what, Chris? I'm not that huge of a fan for beer. That I if I'm gonna drink it, I want to get a little head change. So I know you're not a big drinker, but I'm not into drinking beer just to get the flavor because I don't think it's that good. Hence why I like the fufu drinks. I'm gonna bite. Dude, you can sit down if you want. We're done. We're done advertising here. Oh, good. Thank you, Kent. You rock as well. Love you guys. A nun drank O'Doul's. Well, she gotta drink something. Whew, it's hot. It's hard working under the lights. Hey, cheers, Chris, man. I get what you're saying, for sure. For sure. Cheers for having that willpower, brother. Right on, Brian. Hey, Brian, real quick, are you in the station where my brother's at, or you guys just know each other through the firefighters? Hopefully you didn't jump off yet. I wasn't too sure if you were in Tony's station or not. All right, cool. Is he working right now? Is he there with you? Smack that bitch upside the head for not jumping on and saying hi to his brother. Different shift. Alright. Well, if you run by him at some point, smack that bitch upside the head and tell him why is he not here with watching his brother working hard. But Brian, I was talking to Tony about this, and I was gonna do a fairly huge cook and bring it to you guys. And you know, bring the kids out so they can, you know, play on the fire engines or whatever and see Tony. I was gonna make a big dish and then film it, you know, vlog it style, and then bring it out to you guys. So I'm hoping to do that sometime soon. So hopefully I'll catch you guys at the same shift, and you know, at least you can hang around maybe. All right. Oh my goodness. How many people are?
10.
Huh?
10 to 5. 10.
Okay, got it. Alright, guys. Alright, sounds awesome. Hope for the savings. Well, I'll talk to him and see if we can work out the shift timing so you can, you know, maybe on your way out or on his way in or whatever, work it out, okay? I appreciate you coming by and supporting me, man. That's awesome, you guys. Hi, Donna, how you doing? Kind of came in at the last bit here. Cheers, Brian. Donna, you missed all the good guacamole we made. You'll have to watch the replay. I'm gonna put this up. I'm gonna put the ingredients in the description below, and you guys can follow along. I know what you're saying, Mia. Man, this guacamole is the truth, guys. It's so good. And she's like, welcome on. All right, kid. Take care, brother. You know what? Hold on. I'm going to get Brady down here. I want to get our youngest. He likes guacamole. Brady Jen. Come here, baby. Come here. You're trying to guacamole. All right, come here. Guys, this is Brady Jennings. He's our youngest. He loves guacamole like me. Tell the people what you think. Look at the camera. Right there. When you try it. Is that good? Is that good? Is that good? High five? You got a pound? Damn right. Did he just run into the wall?
Yeah.
Probably
not. I think it was bright young kid and just...
Bright young kid ran right in there. All right, Chris, Mihad, I appreciate you stopping by, man. I know it's late where you're at. I know you've been working hard. Appreciate it. I'll talk to you soon. Again, thanks for the knife, man. So, we focused right?
Check your hat.
Is my hat right?
Yeah, that's fine.
T-Roy! Wow, the man graced us with his presence! What's up, my brother? Oh man, this is exciting! T-Roy, you just missed out on this dope guacamole I made. Alright, I don't know if you see it. It's got roasted corn, it's got bacon in it, roasted jalapeno, roasted tomatoes, secret packet of seasoning that I love to use. You have to watch the replay. Good stuff. T-Roy, we miss you, big guy, man. I know you deserve a vacation, though. You work hard for your money, so, you know, you gotta get some time off. But I need you to come out here to California and come visit me. Show me how to use these stupid grills out there. Do it, man. that's awesome. Cheers to you, T-Roy. T-Roy, you're welcome anytime. We got a 5-bedroom house. We got plenty of room for you guys. We got a pull out bag. That's 5 bedrooms. We built you the bedroom, right? All right, hold tight. I'm going to give you another libation. I'm going to have to switch to whiskey pretty soon. Go outside, have me a stogie. This thing's going down so good. Russian. T-Roy, I got both. Come on out. Hey, listen, man. When Tommy, greatness recognizes greatness. He has to come on and say hi. Oh my goodness, you guys are a good time. Look at that bite. Ah. freaking good, dude. Mimi, you still on? You still hocking in the background? It's not Nicki Minaj. And now you're hungry. All right, cool. Thank you, sir. T-Roy, you got some good stuff too, bro. You were one of the you were my first. You're one of the first ones I watched, man. I love watching you, brother. Mimi, I'm sorry you're hungry now. Call room service. You know what? I don't know why I didn't put out a notice to everybody, but, you know, whatever. I put a little something on Facebook. I didn't know how to schedule the live stream, but I think when I hit play or whatever, I figured out how to do it. So I'll have it ready for next time. I haven't been doing a lot of live stream, but I think I want to start doing more because, click my bell, damn it. You sexy beast. Click that bell. I want to do more live streaming because I want to get my hours watched up, because I'm getting close to the close to the 1,000 the 1,000 subscriber. I'm got about a quarter to go, so I want to get my hours watched up, because I have fairly decent subscriber count, but the hours watched is not where I need to be. So that's what I want to do. I want to do some more live streams, get going for a little bit. So I'm gonna find more kind of easier recipes, and I might do another one tomorrow night where I'm making that sangria I was talking about. It's just find little simple stuff I can do while talking to the camera, and that's it. So. What is the Cucumber Crew?
It's Discord? Yeah. It's a like Skype. But...
Oh, okay. I was looking at this and I'm like...
No. it's a group people I play games with.
Yeah, for sure. T-Roy, are you going to do the Thursday question deal again? Cool. I don't know if you saw, but I just got a Weber kettle. So I'm off the gasser. I mean, I'm still using it. Don't get me wrong. It's easy to use. But I got me a Weber kettle for Father's Day, an early Father's Day gift. So I did ribs on it. And I just put that video out last Sunday, I think. Yeah, Sunday. And the ribs turned out awesome. It was like I beat my nemesis. Because my past attempts at ribs on the gasser, even with the smoke box that you told me to get, so long ago, it just worked out so much better on the kettle. And I added some wood chips to it, cooked it offset, and it was just amazing. Wrapped it. I think the biggest thing I had problems with is not having the patience on the ribs. Just was cooking them too fast, wasn't paying attention to doing it. And it just didn't turn out what I wanted. So when I did it on the Weber kettle, did it offset, smoked it for 2 hours, wrapped it with the brown sugar and the honey and the apple juice, and it just turned out freaking amazing. So juicy, tender. T-Bone, you liked it, right?
What?
You like my ribs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. So, yeah, Gregor, T-Roy Cooks, he's the man, dude. Go check him out. He's been doing this since God was a kid, right? He's one of the old school YouTubers. How long we gone?
45.
All right, cool. All right, guys and gals, I'm gonna wrap this up. Eat a little bit more of this guacamole. Had a house cigar. Switch the crown after this. All right, I'll check that out, T-Roy. I love the, dude, I'm just loving anything you cook, dude. Just, you guys look like you're having a blast, and it's so cool. I love it, like when you and Baby Bad Guy, Justin, it's Baby Bad Maniac. You guys look like you had a blast too. So, and Kenny, that was a good time. I want to be a part of that sometime. It's gonna be great to do a little collaboration at someone's house, like a home cook. So I reached out, you know, like Kirby from Kirby's Fishing and Grill, talked about coming up. Talked to AB, Aaron Brown, he's coming up. Justin, Jason. You know, T-Roy, my, the J in CJ is Justin. And honestly, most people in my life call me Justin. And so I just did CJ for the channel because my first name is Charles. So, when I was younger, people would call me CJ. But I just did it because, you know, cooking with CJ sounded better than cooking with Justin, you know. So, it's funny when people talk about Justin or talk, you know, when he's on, you know, the chats or whatever, and they're like, hey, Justin, you know, great cook on whatever. It catches me off guard sometimes because I'm like, oh, yeah, that's right. So, anyway, AB is great. He lives close to me. So, we were talking about maybe doing something this weekend. I haven't heard from him yet. But if you can come up, we're gonna do a live stream here. So, right on. And then my son is Charles. Very cool. Yeah, one of our kids, his middle name is Charles. My dad's name is Charles. So we got a lot of, the dog's name is Charlie. So got a lot of Charles going on up in here. So, but
who's the middle kid with the name Charles?
Grady. Yeah, you guys, dude, seriously, you guys need to come out. Justin looks like he's a good time, too. He looks like you had a great time, so that's cool. Ron, you've been lurking this whole time. I haven't seen you jump on there. But yeah, dude, this guacamole is the truth. And I'm telling you, is it traditional Mexican guacamole? No, it's a what I like to call bastardized California version. But it's pretty damn good, so. Oh, man. Yeah, James from In and Claiming. Yeah, that guy's a good dude, too, Nigel. I like watching what he's got going on, too. I you know, most of you guys in Texas, I need to, thank you, Amy. I need to make a trip out to Texas. I think it'd be cool. Our company has a branch in Dallas that I was out there a couple years ago. I had a great time out there. I went to Heart 8 Barbecue. So I don't know if that's a good place or not, but it was pretty damn tasty to me. So that was cool. But I really want to make it out there. I want to come do one of these live trips, live cooks, or even like how you guys did with that big ass burger. That would pull on a nice offset. All right, brother. You know I'm going to take you up on that one of these days. Me and Mr. CJ is going to show up with 5 kids. Let's go. Band slightly stupid, more about. All right, slightly stupid. I got it. We'll you know, check that out. Get on that Google. Get on the Google machine, and we'll find them. Gregor, where are you from, dude? Where do you lay your head? Ooh, Dungeons crab. Oh, I love crab. So good. Am I near San Diego? Yeah, about a
hour most, right?
Probably an hour and a half. I'm right up the 15 in Rancho Cucamonga. So that's probably a good 2 hours from San Diego. Big Sky at the moment, so that's Montana, right? I think? Maybe? Alright. Or Wyoming? Big Sky is Montana, right? Jump on there, let me know if you're. My cameraman got lazy and just left the camera on the stand instead of holding it.
It's been like that for the past 10 minutes.
Montana, got it. I just know it's Big Sky because of the football, Big Sky League. And that's where Big Sky Conference. That's where Montana plays. Big fan of college football. All right, guys and gals, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night. Head out to the back, chill out for a little bit. I appreciate everybody stopping by, for real. I mean, I love doing this live stream stuff. And I'm saying goodnight, Joey B. Appreciate you stopping by, brother. Listen, hit that like button if you haven't already. Chef Johnny, thank you for stopping by. T-Roy, thank you for stopping by. Nigel, Gregor, everybody. Very cool. Emmy, appreciate you stopping by. Donna, you're awesome. Thank you so much. I'm going to call it a night. T-Bone, shut this bad boy off. Cheers, everybody.